guys, it's 8 o'clock in the morning. And for those of you who are on this call, I see so many new numbers. Okay, we've got a ton of people on the call. We're generally averaging about 600 to 700 people on these calls. And then they're being shared to our database. We get about 30,000 requests for the calls. So this is why we've muted you guys, is to actually just make sure that we don't have any background noise and we can just go ahead and record it. So I've got really somebody I love on the call, and we've got some exciting stuff. Not really going to tell you too much about it, but I am going to introduce this amazing person. Her name is Valerie. She is absolutely fantastic. She is the VP of Operations for the Knighton Real Estate Advisors, and she is literally the person who runs all the background stuff. She's also a coach. She's amazing. She's a coach to other admins, which is awesome, which leads me into something to announce, not officially, but just to give you a little taste. Val and I are going to, she is going to be the CEO of a new coaching company branch that we're opening up. And I will be in the background with her. She's going to be the lead of it because she is amazing. So stay tuned because, yeah, you're going to see. I don't partner with many people, but when I saw Val and I, we kind of, our worlds kind of came together at the exact time when I was looking for somebody to branch out to. Our worlds collided. And for me, it's important, as you guys know, I lead with contribution. And finding somebody who also leads with contribution, who's willing to give back at times that people need it, but also at the same token has a really high level of integrity and also really has that same drive that I've built our coaching company for agents on, which is that drive for you guys to succeed. She shares, Val shares the exact same drive and passion to build on the administrative side. And that to me was a perfect, perfect marriage. So my gut is always right. So here is Val. What Val's going to do moving forward, we're going to literally, and I'm going to talk to her a little bit about this on the side. She doesn't know a lot of this stuff, but we're going to start to introduce you to her, have her help your admins in this time where you guys really need us. And then stay tuned. In the future, very soon future, you're going to see that there's some really cool stuff that she's going to be launching out, some admin stuff, some group coaching, other things that can really help you guys in the future. So for now, though, please take the support that she gives. Take these calls. She's extremely talented, and we are going to interview her today and start this process up and see if we can pour into your admins and get these admins busy, busy, busy in this time of change. So without further ado, I just want to say, Val, welcome to the call.
Woo! Oh, my God. Thank you so much. Like, I wanted to thank you off the bat for everything, and you just brought tears to my eyes. Like, you're wonderful. Aww. Thank you.
I love it. Well, you know what, guys? Listen, there's a massive need for it, and we've built the company based on, like I said, we built the company on contribution. I'm very proud that we're the first company to, beyond everybody, that's including the Tony Robbins and the Tom Ferrys and everything, we're the first company that went out publicly and said, we're opening calls up. We're going to quadruple our coaching. We're going to offer the group calls for free, no gimmicks, no nothing associated with it. And that to me was, it was just awesome because you were also the person who came up and said, what can I do to help? What can I do? How can we pour into the admins? That's how I knew that we were in the right position. So I love the fact that we're trailblazing as a company, and I love the fact that these calls are really making a difference in people's lives. So so let's get this thing started. Val, how is your, you know, let's talk about it first. How is your team pivoting? This week has been the most interesting week, and I'm curious how you guys pivoted.
So our team on Monday made the executive decision, shut down our office, and work virtually. So a lot of our team is tech savvy, which is really amazing. We were able to jump in without zero issues in terms of the technology side of things. Our team has pivoted so amazing. Like, I don't know how else to describe it. They took this opportunity to rework their business, create a new system every single day, and it's been flawless for us. So I'm super proud of how our team has adapted to what's going on. It wasn't easy. There was a, you know, Monday was a bit of a hiccup for everybody figuring out who's going to do this and what's going to do that. But the good thing is we had so many amazing people already in place. Like, our admin team is rock solid. So that was one of the best things for our team during this pivot.
Amazing. I like hearing that. So, and I'm just kind of curious, are you seeing success with your team right now? Is this something that you're seeing?
Yes.
I mean, it's week one. We can all go week by week. So are you seeing some success with your team?
I am. So what we've been doing is we've been trying to gauge, like, what this week has looked like for everybody. And showings haven't stopped for our buyer agents. So they're still out there showing, and they've switched to the virtual world as well. We have had some people who've allowed them into their homes to do showings. So for us, success this week, because we built such a strong business and our agents work extremely hard every single day, this change for us this week was all just about how to adapt to the clients in a way that's beneficial for them. So we've been very successful because we've always been very relationship-based, that we were able to take all the stuff that we know and how much we love our clients and just keep converting that, like pivoting is the perfect word. So we've just changed the way we've looked at things daily right now. In terms of success, we're still full force. Like, I'm so impressed with these people every single day getting up, doing their lead gen. Nothing stopped them. In fact, they're more driven because they know what they do today is going to be what makes them more successful 3 months from now as well.
Oh, totally. And also, here's the thing, right? Just kind of a dialogue between you and I. When you see a team react like that, that's got to give you, as the VP of operations, you know, your salary, you could be laid off if the team isn't into production. So that's got to give you somewhat a bit of confidence with the team to say, okay, I can breathe, right? Like, you must have been a little scared at first and went, holy smokes, what's going to happen to me?
Yeah, you know what? There was a brief moment. I don't really watch the news, but there was a brief moment where I did listen to the news, and I felt like I needed to inform my team step by step where things were going, how our real estate board was doing things, what other brokerages were doing. And then it kind of almost put me in this tunnel a little bit where it's like, okay, Val, this isn't your normal mindset. And if I'm thinking this way, are they feeling that? So our team we're built on culture. We're built on relationship, and we're built because we have the right people in place. So when something like this happens, success isn't just about going and getting a deal done. Success for us this week has been connecting with our clients on a whole new level. Being able to help people get pre-approved that couldn't be pre-approved recently with all the mortgage changes and the price drops. So we've had so many small success stories this week. And thinking about being laid off, I don't actually put that in my head because you kind of said it, and I think of it too, is if I'm thinking of being laid off, then I gave up on my team, right? So that's how I kind of look at that. It means that I didn't have the right stuff in place to keep them going, to keep my job intact. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes total sense. And I think the thing that I want to just kind of drop on everybody on this call, as admins, guys, so I'm going to direct my conversation to anybody who is an admin listening to this call. This is a time for you to become a leader. Okay,
yes.
So just to touch on that really quickly, if you're getting laid off, okay, because not everybody on this call administratively is going to sit there and go, oh, this is fantastic, this is great, you know, I'm not worried about getting laid off. I know some of you are going to be on this phone call going, holy smokes, my leader isn't around, or I don't know what to do, or, you know, there's talk about, hey, how do I lay this person off? Or in some cases, if you're an independent contractor on a team, you may be cut. So I want you to just remember, at the end of this phone call, I'm going to talk about some innovative ways that you guys can actually, those of you who are at risk and want to continue an income, will give you some ways that you can actually do it. So just remember, Amen. The word is pivot. This is pivot. So it's just kind of, you know, when something changes in the world, you've got to kind of look at yourself as a leader. And you guys on this phone call, you're leaders, okay? You're leading teams, you're leading agents, you're doing what you got to do. So this is a time where you've got to really look and go, great, it's time of change. It's a little bit nerve-wracking for some people. But the reality is that it's going to be a moment in time. So it becomes pivoting to that moment in time. And really what the attitude you bring is going to really make a huge difference. So let's just talk about this. What's changed in your role right now within the team? How has your role changed?
It's in terms of support. So outside of systems and models, because those are good, we just pivoted them virtually. But my role has changed in a way that I'm leading differently these days. So our conversations are swinging differently in ways that we're more motivational than we've ever been before. And there's more, you know, here's what's going on, and let's focus on that for just a second, because here's how we're going to take care of that. So every morning I do an admin huddle virtually with my admins. I miss them. I miss everyone's faces. So So we get on that call every single morning.
You wouldn't miss mine right now if you saw it, just so you know. That's why we're not doing this on video.
I agree with you. You should see what I look like.
I don't know, man. I'm like, this week, you know, I have a face for radio this week. That's for sure. Okay, so you're missing your admins, right? So your role has changed where you have to communicate very differently with them, which I understand, right?
Yeah, it's more of like deeper coaching than I've ever coached someone before, because I want to make sure they're okay. And our team has this way of not sharing a lot of like concerns. They kind of like to deal with it, like our admin girls, because they're worried that if they're thinking that and they say it and they put it out in the environment. So I always make them feel like we're open to have these conversations. Let's talk about it, because once we're done, we're going to move on now, and we're going to move on to the good stuff.
Has anybody, like, how do you let them know that you're open to talk about their concerns, but you don't want them to dwell on their concerns? How are you telling your admin team within your team that message? How do you communicate that instead of going down that rabbit hole or being a team that says, I don't want to hear anything negative? So how do you have that balance? How are you kind of coaching them through that?
That's actually such an amazing question, because I feel every single day I'm getting stronger and stronger with that conversation. So Monday started out with, okay, so here's the reality, guys. This is what's going on. Let's take a few minutes, talk about it, get familiar with what's happening with our real estate board, what's happening with our team, and does anyone have any concerns? I gave them open floor. So, and they're really good at communicating. So if there was any issues, they would have definitely addressed them. We didn't see anything the first day. It wasn't until Wednesday you can start feeling how everyone's like, okay, well, like, what's next week going to look like? And what's this? And so now we're starting to see those questions. And just being completely honest with them. This is what it's going to look like. Here's what I'm hoping the direction we go into for the next couple of days. And you and, like, the four of us, every single day, we've got each other's back. So there's never been any negativity. There's never been any doubt. I guess that's the word to use with them, because I've made it very clear right from the beginning, we've got this. We're strong. Our systems are strong. And we just have to rely on each other. And if we're having a weak moment, call me. Call me ASAP. Let's talk about it so we don't have to dwell on it. Just like you said, that simple. Giving them the floor to talk whenever they do feel that way.
I love hearing that, because, guys, here's the thing. As administrators in our teams and in our offices, we've got to be ultra strong at this time. Okay, so that means, like, the positive attitude. Be very careful, because one of my backgrounds with mindset is that the more somebody talks about doom and gloom, the more you're going to end up in doom and gloom. And here's the reality. This is a week-by-week assessment. Guess what? This week, the markets were really good, by the way. This week, if you're looking at a three-day stat and you're an admin on this call, go into the MLS system and share some positive news with the team and be like, hey, guys, and that's what I'm asking a lot of admins to do, because the agents are really busy right now. So any positivity that you can bring to keep the team understanding that the market is still moving, remember something really interesting. I'm going to say this at my call at noon. The market a week ago, okay, as a coach to 700 people, I'm telling you, last week, we didn't know it was going to be like this. I mean, you look at my Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday calls, they only started turning Friday afternoon. Okay, so at that point, we were like, uh-oh, this is going to happen, right? So we knew it was going to happen at some level, but most of our clients, like buyers, sellers, and all that stuff, they still need to get into places if this does go into a place where we are quarantined for a little time. So the truth is that you have to, if you're an admin on this call, which there's a ton of you I'm seeing, pull up the market stats for your team members from Friday the 13th. But anyway, from Friday the 13th to today, do a 7-day snapshot. Look at what's active. So all the active listings that came on the market, what are the conditionally sold, and what are the sold, what is under agreement, all that kind of stuff. And just that's actually, most of the markets are really positive. I haven't come across a market that's not. So bring those stats in, and just, you know, maybe before you leave for the day, just go, hey, guys, I just want to bring the stats. You know, keep positive over the weekend. Next 3 days, look at the sales that are happening, or look at the results that are happening. So just, you know, as admins, kind of share a little bit of good news with that. Now, you mentioned something about systems. You said you're pretty confident that you have the right system to carry you through this. So talk to me a little bit about what system you feel is one of the most important ones at this time.
So for us, the system is the communication. So that would probably be our best system right now, outside of our normal, which is making sure your listings are intact. So what we did before we left the office, just to go back a little bit, is we knew we were leaving the office, so we prepped blank listing paperwork for the agents. Everyone got enough files to take with them because we all left the office, and we want to make sure we set them up for success for the entire week. So we did an average of how many listing appointments we go on a week. We made sure every single one of them, our listing agents, had files. On our buyer side, we made sure that they were set up and they knew that, you know, scan your documents to us. We've got your vendors. We'll take care of the mortgage brokers, the lawyers. We could do it all virtually. So the system for us right then and there was the communication to the client or to our agents, letting them know that we're here for you guys no matter what. I text every single morning when we wake up, and I send them all good morning. Today I just did like good morning, it's Friday, and one person actually was like, oh my God, today's Friday. So just letting them know we're here for them, that's the biggest thing. Because our other systems that we've been working on for years and we're tweaking them every single day, they're good. They were good. They could sustain this. We could work virtually from home.
It's really a matter of taking the systems and saying, okay, team, we're about to hunker down into a new reality of virtual stuff. So here's how we're going to virtually do this. Here's how we're going to virtually do that. So the admins that are on this call, make sure you understand your team members or your team leader, whoever you have on your team at this level, they're looking like they've got to be hunkering down on other things. So having everything proactively, where you go, okay, pick up a phone, like Val's saying, pick up a phone, call the lawyers and be like, okay, we're going to be looking at possibly closing in this kind of market. How do we virtually work with you? Boom. Home inspectors, call them. Be proactive for your teams and just be like, how do we do business virtually in all the areas? Pick up your phone, call a photographer. Be like, look, what are our solutions at this point? Yes. If we take on two or three listings during this time, don't wait for that. Just be like, how do we operate everything virtually? Don't wait for your team leaders to say, hey, how do I do this? Because that's probably going to happen in a very stressful time where they're like, ah, how do I do this? So if you can proactively be like, here's my virtual, you know, I've called the lawyer. Here's how the lawyer said to operate virtually. And here's their new standards. And here's their new hours. Here is the, you know, inspectors. And this is what they're suggesting. Here are their hours. Here's how they want us to book the appointments. Here's how we do this. So really just take what Val was saying and be like, prepare. Be like, here's how we're going to do business virtually. That is a great help to be proactive at a time where your agents and your team rainmakers are a little bit stressed out. And you know what? That's going to really go a long way to be like, holy smokes, thank you, if you make their business virtual, right?
That's right. And then just to add on to that, the one more thing I would add to that is moving forward from whatever changes you've made to your systems and models, however you've pivoted the business, document it all. That's a new system right there. So creating new scripts. How you're working virtually, so that way someone, whoever steps into your role, they can take and go with it. Should this ever happen again, where you have to work virtually for a long period of time?
100%. So now, how are you helping? So if you're actually, let's not say your team specifically. So as you guys know, I was telling you, Val coaches VPs of admins and operation admins and all that on teams. So if you're with a small team. So let's say it's just a one person kind of show, maybe two people. What can the admin do at this time beyond what we've just talked about to help bring their business forward, to kind of be like, okay, they need my help. What can they be doing right now for the next week until we have another call?
I love this question. So I have answered this a lot today or this week, and this is probably my favorite question. So everybody, like if you're taking notes, this is the note to take. The number one thing to do is start taking advantage of your own sphere of influence. Reach out to your own SOI. Get on social media. Start sharing things through your team's page. If you're a solo admin with just an agent or just a couple agents on your team, start utilizing your team's page for social media, sharing museums to tour. Everyone's doing it right now, and I think it's a great idea. Tackling your own sphere of influence. Adding those people to the database, having conversations that you couldn't really have before because you were incredibly busy with work. Mm-hmm. This is now part of your work. Bring those people into your environment. Share with them what's going on. Have meaningful conversations. You guys can actually pick up the phone and not even stress about having to have a real estate conversation and breaking any rules. You can actually call with value. Call the database. Call past clients that you haven't talked to in a really long time just to check in.
I like that. So you're saying, so the admins, and by the way, I fully endorse this, because here's the thing, guys. We know a lot of admins have a very certain profile, right? So their profile might be like, hells no, I do not want to pick up the phone. Like, that is not what I signed up for. I like to be behind the scenes. Do not make me pick up a phone. How do you coach your admins to say, look, I get it. This is out of your comfort zone, but we need this to happen. So how are you coaching around that mindset? Because that's a big one.
Yeah, it is. It basically is just that. I'll script practice with somebody over it. I did a call on Wednesday with someone exactly the same, very introvert, and didn't really want to call the database. So I asked her who her most favorite client was that she has worked with since she's been with this agent. She told me their name. I'm like, when was the last time you actually spoke to them? Mm-hmm. And she's like, well, you know, however long it was. And I'm like, let's call them today to say hi. They've obviously touched your heart to a point where you remembered them as your favorite client. When was the last time you've actually called just to see how they were doing in their new home and or,
right,
you know? So it's that type of conversation to have. And it's, a lot of us are nervous. I was there too. A lot of us get nervous to pick up the phone because I used to stress that they were going to ask me, well, what's the market look like to you? And I very much protect how I answer the questions for our team. I never want to step outside my role and answer anything that might jeopardize. That was my headset, my mindset, like years ago. And then I started calling people and just to say hi, like, we had a client, her name was Marianne. I'm like, but it's not just Marianne.
We know she's just using that fakely, by the way. Yes, okay.
And she was actually the very first client that touched my heart when I worked with our team. So I called her. I called her on Monday just to say, how are things looking for you? Is there anything I can do? She moved to our city, and she's probably about 65 to 70. So she hit that target, and she was the first person that popped into my mind. Val 2 years ago probably wouldn't have called her, but I knew it's important to my team that I double down with them. So whatever I have them double down doing and whatever they're doing, I want to do it with them. I'm here for them. I'm here to protect my role, to show them that I can do this alongside of you guys.
I love what you just said. And so to all the VPs of ops and the admins on this call, look, we get it. Like, we get it that is going to be way out of your comfort zone. Mm-hmm. But let me tell you something. We sent out an email the other day to our admins, our team, our coaches and everything. And I said, look, first of all, I've just never been this impressed. Like, I'm so impressed as a CEO. I'm going, holy smokes, the people who are stepping up and the people who are helping us and all that kind of great stuff. But I'm seeing it and I'm going, I'm aware enough to know that our admin team right now, they are not playing in their comfort zone. I know that. So we've got contingencies. We got surprises in store for them and things like that, that we're going to really be like, hey, listen, they're pouring in, but don't think it's not going noticed.
Yeah.
And I want you to remember, it's really going noticed. It's just right now, it's all hands on deck. And it's kind of like one of those things. If you're going into a storm, guys, and I want you to think about this. If we're all on a boat, and we're on, let's say we're on a party boat and we're like, all right, we're having a great time. We're celebrating a great year. And we're going, this has been a great start to the year. By the way, it has for almost every team. And they're like, yeah, everything's going great. And we're all in this party boat. And then we're in the middle of the ocean. And all of a sudden we're like, oh my gosh, here comes a storm. That's exactly what's just happened, right? Now, it's not doom and gloom because the storm is far in the distance and we're like, there's the storm. And then we're hearing and we're like, storm, storm. And everybody starts going, it's the storm coming. We need all hands on deck. So it's like, if we're going to pivot away from the storm, we need everybody rowing. So that means the cook, the chef, the cleaner of the thing, everybody's got to be rowing. The only way you're going to get out of a storm is if everybody is rowing together. And that means you may not be strong. You may be like, holy smokes, I'm terrible at something, but your rowing is helping. And that's one of the things I'm saying to everybody. I'm going, it's all hands on deck. You're not going to be rowing out of the storm for a long time, hopefully, and then all stats show shouldn't be too long. However, you're going to have to row. And it's like, we know that everybody who helped row is really out of their comfort zone or they're doing things they've never done before. So don't focus on the how. Don't focus on perfection. Just do what Val said. Ask your team, say, hey, I'm going to call my database first. Do the check-ins. I'm coaching all the agents, guys, on this. I'm telling them, hands down, they should be calling their database physically. Please do not, as admins, think that video message is okay. Please do not think that text message is okay or a random group email. This is the time where you've got to work with your team to say they need to physically get a phone call from you to say, hey, I'm just checking in. Is there anything real estate-wise that you have questions about that I can filter back, get you some answers? Do you have any concerns right now? Simple as that, but keep it real estate-wise, okay? So to all you amazing ops directors and bosses, make sure that you keep it real estate focused. We made a mistake last week, and we actually were making the calls, and we didn't say real estate related at first, and we ended up on these 30-minute calls at a time where everybody was, they're like, well, actually, I didn't get toilet paper. And you know what? My neighbor got back. I know my neighbor got back from vacation in Florida, and they're out walking around. And I was like, oh my gosh, we're in a rabbit hole. And I listened to the script. I'm like, there it is. We forgot to say real estate related. So super
That's a good
important.
Point.
Yeah. Be very careful. There's way too many things that we can really talk about. Okay, so that's one thing that you guys can be doing to help out is to say, hey, yeah, let's do the phone calls to your database first. And then second suggestion would be to pick up the calls for your agents. So if they're too busy because they're running around trying to generate revenue, remember, it's all hands on deck, which means your activities should not be activities that aren't moving you guys forward over the next week. So be really proactive. Check in with all your clients. That's rule number one. So if you see that your teams aren't reaching out physically, offer to help. And just rip the Band-Aid off and do it. And if you need accountability or if you need some extra help with that, just reach out to Val and she'll help you out with it. Okay,
Absolutely. Give
me another idea. Let's hear of another one. What else are you
going
to do?
So definitely showing the support. So reaching out to the agents and supporting them in a way we've never really supported them before is the other thing too. So one of the girls that I was coaching this week, one of her top priorities this week is to set them up for success. So every day she's picking their area that they're going to lead gen still. So she's calling them, every single agent. There's four agents on her team, so it's not like a big job, but it's big enough for her where she's calling every single one of them, giving them their target place, and she's basing it on what they wanted their potential farm area to be. So we all talk about farming and whatnot, but some of our agents never really get to implementing it. We've taken the back, and she had a great idea, and I'm actually going to start encouraging our team to do the same thing as well, where we made the decision on our call where she's now going to figure out where their actual farm areas were and start giving them the neighborhoods to call, the codes to call through the Mojo dialer that we use or they use. So
awesome.
Now she's digging deep into the farming. So, and just to take on to the last thing, every action we do right now, everything that we do to set our team up for success, whether it's calling our own sphere, getting that farm area set up for those agents that they've been talking about for weeks, months, years, everything happens. And that'll all come back to you 3 months from now, guys. Imagine the revenue you create for yourself because you've been building this pipeline for your team during this week.
Mm-hmm. So Val just touched on something that really amazing. Okay. And I know, like I said, guys, we know what we're dealing with right now as far as, you know, you guys aren't agents on this call. You may be agents listening because you want to coach your admins a little bit better. But please, there's a ton of you on this phone call. So if you're a CEO on this phone call, do not hoard this phone call. Share it with your admins. Give them. Yeah, I'm a little surprised with this. So don't hoard it. Okay, give this call to your admins and say, hey, guys, it's going to be on our Facebook site today. Within a couple hours, this will be posted and shared with everybody. So please just give it to your admins and say, here you go. But to parlay to what Val was saying, for those operations directors and VP of admins and real estate assistants on this call, what Val just said, the second point now, so the first point was call your own sphere, check in with them, see how they're doing if they need any help from your team, CEOs, and agents. You would be shocked at how many people need help or they're worried about the market or they're concerned. You don't have to answer the questions. Just be very cautious when they ask you something. Say, hey, you know what I'm willing to do? I'm willing to get my CEO to reach out to you. What's the most important question you have right now? Your CEO will be thrilled to do that. That's totally proactive. Then the second part of that is you're done with your database, then you absolutely make sure that you're on your team and say, hey, who hasn't called their database? I'll pick up some heavy lifting while you guys are out, you know, generating revenue. This next week and a half is very important for them to be out generating revenue. So the rowing of the ship is you helping, saying, okay, I'll pick up the slack. I'll do those calls. Even if you do 20, 30 check-ins a day, I'll tell you, I would like literally come and give you a hug when this is all over, obviously, with very washed hands. I will come and give you a personal hug because that is epically amazing if you knew that. Second part of what Val was saying is really take a look and see. Ask your team what lead generation is most important to you right now and then proactively help them. Agents are running at the fastest pace they've probably ran in a while. And if they're not right now, it will change that they're running very fast in the next little while. So best thing you can do is set them up for success and say, all right, just what Val said. If it's a farm area, then great. Compose the list for them and really be proactive about it. If your agent says, you know what, like go back and look at all the open house leads that you've had for the past year, compose a call list for them and go, here's all the open house leads, guys. You need to circle through these. Done. Next thing, here's a farm area. You've always wanted a farm in ABC area. I've composed the list for you. Here you go. Done. Don't go to your team CEOs and stuff and say, how do I do this? That's not the time to do this, okay? Reach out to Val or reach out to other support, whatever it is, and don't bring it to your CEOs or rainmakers because they're busy doing other stuff. Just know what they want for lead gen and then figure out how to do it. So like I said, if it's farm area, like Val said, accumulate the farm list. So Val, how do you accumulate a farm list? Curious.
So how do we, we've done, I'll take one of our agents, for instance, is he lives in this certain section in Hamilton. So he's like, I want to dominate this neighborhood. So we went to Canada Post. We figured out what all the postal codes were in that neighborhood.
Canada Post by the way, guys. Super easy.
Yeah, Canada Post
to
online. Oh, so it's very easy. I can send instructions later out if anyone wants to know.
We would love that. Okay, and we'll post them on our site. Yes, okay.
Yeah. So then we figure out what the postal codes are, and we start the first mail out. So then that was about 6 months ago. So, and now continuously every month we do the same thing consistently to that area with his face on the mail out, the address. Sorry, not the address. If it's home evaluation, market report, whatever that is, we put all that information on and send it out in a mail out. So it was very easy to find the postal codes. The hardest part was getting the agents to narrow down the neighborhood they wanted to. So we sat down with them and we said, okay, so here's like, you've got 500 here to 10,000 homes. Let's start with your inner core. So we started with 500. Then even if we take our team, for instance, when I first started with the team, we started with 2,500 mail outs. Our team now does 10,000 mail outs to our farm.
Perfect. So that is awesome advice. So farm areas is another thing. Finding those past open house leads, another thing. Online leads, super important too. This is a great time for you guys to follow up with online leads. It's amazing. So even as, so from an operations standpoint, how could all the assistants and the VPs, what could they do with online leads? Is there anything that they can do to help?
Oh, absolutely. So online leads for us right now is Facebook. We have our marketing director handling all the leads that come in. And there was a time where we couldn't get to them fast enough, and we didn't really have a system in place to who was going to tackle them after hours. This girl just stepped up and she's like, I've got this. She handles it as soon as they come in. We have a script in place that we send out immediately.
Tell us about it. I want to hear it. What does it say?
Yeah. Actually, you know what? Let me pull it up. You're going to put me right
on the spot.
Yeah,
let's hear it. Let's give everybody value. Like, you know, you guys want it? We'll give it. While she's pulling it up, while Val is pulling it up, I'm just going to say is that what she just said was another key nugget. And sometimes we miss these because, you know, we zone out sometimes or whatever. But remember, it's a time where you can actually just go to your CEO and be like, hey, if they have an issue with maybe having nobody from 5 o'clock onwards, maybe that's something that you talk to your admin about as well, or your CEO and your rainmakers about as well. And you say, hey, listen, nobody's following up with things in the evening. I can easily do this from home, you know, maybe because you're going to be working from home. Maybe it's a matter of saying, look, from 12 o'clock to 4 o'clock, you're going to be with the kids or whatever, because a lot of you have shifted that way. And then don't be afraid to say 12 to 4, you know, I'm going to be with the kids and stuff and doing things, but I'll work in the morning and let's shift me to do 4 hours in the evening. Like, we're seeing a lot of that. And I have to be honest with you, that's pretty cool. So don't worry about that too. If you feel that, oh my gosh, my world, and I can, you know, like Val said, marketing director is now following up with leads in the evening. That's pretty awesome. That's a good shift because like Val said, there was an opportunity where you realize we weren't keeping up with the leads. Therefore, boom, now she's put something in place. Love it. Okay. Did you find it?
This environment. Yeah, I found it. So this environment has created us to take advantage of the gaps we had in our systems. And I'll never say our systems are perfect, but I will say I always thought they were pretty strong. So this is showing us where we've had a few gaps, which is amazing because we've been able to tackle it. And our administrative team is just like, yeah, I've got this. So I'll share another tip with you right after this. So when someone messages us, the most important thing on our team is we never want to speak or communicate via messenger or email. It's very important for us to get them on the phone and build that rapport instantly. So if someone messages us through Facebook, our scripting right back to them is, thanks for messaging us. We're happy to help. What's the best email and number to reach you at? And look forward to hearing from you from the Knighton Real Estate Advisors. So that gauges how serious someone is. Some people who give you your number right away, I'm like, bam, call that person and instantly start that conversation.
I love it. So Facebook, how can admins, let's kind of look at this, because now that we're moving really fast with our consumers online, and on top of that, people are going to be spending, by the way, guys, a year ago, people were spending an average of 2 hours a day on social media. This past year, before this happened, people had decreased it to 17 minutes a day. So they were moving faster. Wow. Yeah, we have pivoted now, obviously, that people are quarantined more. They are online probably 4+ hours a day. So there is a massive online opportunity to reach people, have conversation, things like that. So what could an administrative person in a real estate team creatively, what are some things that they could be doing online to kind of maybe help the team a little, get a little bit of exposure, but not spend a lot of money, but really help generate and move some business forward through communication and business?
So that's actually a really good question. That was going to be my third step for things that we can take control of for the business for them right now outside of the farming is social media. So on Monday, we sat down as a team. Well, we didn't sit down. It was all virtual. We sat down and came up with having social media posts ready for the agents. So we created packages for them. So all they have to say, and that was so that way they only had to focus on getting the business, lead gen, follow up, all of that stuff. We were like, what can we take off their plate right now that they do often to help protect their time? And it was, we came up with packages of social media stuff. So
explain that.
You know, so I'm trying to think of off the top of my head. I just said a lot. I don't know why, maybe because it's early in the morning. One of the things we do
is— Or you're
is
a prime minister, one or the other.
Or that, maybe one day.
Maybe one day. No, I'm kidding, go ahead.
I would rock it if that's all I had
you
to say.
You would be really good at that. No, I'm kidding. All
so
good.
We would do things like virtual tours, set up your virtual tour, call us for a free market report, and then we would brand it for the team. So it was social media branding. And then also what we do, and if you check out Knighton Real Estate Advisors on Facebook, you'll see that we have, and we agreed to this on Monday as well as a team, we post when we've sold a property, closing day, firmed up, whatever, this we celebrate it. We put the agent's image in that post, and then we share it.
Mm-hmm. I saw
so
that.
Everyone shares it. Yeah. And that's how we celebrate our wins from afar with each other. And then it's also just making sure that you're connecting. So if someone responds to your post online, make sure you reach out to them. Try to get their telephone number. Try to build that your own database for the client or for your agents. And then obviously bringing the business back to the team.
Okay. Val just rocked that one. Okay. So really look for the nuggets in that. Okay, you really want to be, you want to be working on building that database, okay? So that database still, it's business still as usual in the sense of, remember the database, there's nothing wrong with building it. Okay, there are a lot of people, I keep saying this, I had a really interesting call yesterday where somebody was like, I think it's tacky that realtors are showing, that they're selling places or they're doing this or doing that. I said, look, it's doom and gloom on a lot of the news channels, which I think, you know, from perspective-wise, we have to be careful about what we filter into our brain. But the other thing you have to remember, guys, is that there are tons. If you want to really see what's happened in real estate and why it's busy right now, because there were so many people that ended up buying or selling their houses in the last 60 days, they need to find the realtors who are still working. They have to, because they bought a house and they need to sell theirs. And what are they supposed to do now? If every realtor shut down and said, well, I'm done, and, excuse me, and I'm not going to post anything. By the way, those of you who know me know I'm super healthy. That was just that was a coffee because I'm drinking coffee at the same time, and it's actually apparently I can't do the same thing. I can't talk and drink coffee. Anyway, I've just learned that. Anyhow, long story short, they're looking for realtors who can help them. So be really cautious about your opinion on that when we're sitting here going, because a lot of people are going, wow, look at the Knighton team. They're putting a ton of stuff online about the houses they're selling, the markets they're moving. Are they oblivious? No, they're not oblivious. Their team has really put their social media game on major movement forward because you're optimistic, but you're also showing people that your team is open for all those people who are in a situation that maybe others don't understand, where they bought a house, now they have to sell it, or maybe they sold their house 2 weeks ago and they were just getting excited because they were starting their house hunting initiative, and now they're going, oh, this is great. Every realtor out there, nobody's doing anything. So be cautious about that. Now, here's another tip. So I love what Val just said. Be really, really proactive. So go to your office, take a look at the exclusives, and I'm going to be sharing this with the agents today. Go to the office. If you're working for a smaller team and you're going, we don't have any listings to post and we're not selling anything, that's okay. Go to your office, ask other agents. This is a time where I'm so in love with the agents helping other agents right now. Mm-hmm. Go to agents in the office and say, look, we got nothing and we got to keep our business going. So is there a possibility that your most recent sale, can we share that? You know, is that okay? You know, just be respectful of that, but do that. If there's exclusive listings that are vacant in your office, it's okay to go to the agent and say, look, is that house going to still be for sale? Great. Can I advertise that? You know, so really just go and get the extra hand. Now, if you're on this call and you're like, my office has no exclusives and no agent is going to share, then you know what? I'm going to be honest with you. This is a time where I've seen such remarkable things. Don't hold back as an admin. Find the agents that you've done really great business with, that are really kind, that you've really appreciated. And I don't care if they're with another company. You know what? Maybe talk to them and say, hey, you did a sale in this area. Is there any possibility we can talk about it online? Be creative. That's where you're going to get a lot of extra points in my world, personally speaking. So I think that's a really good point. So social media, also what Val said, get on top of it. So if you're doing what Val said, you know, be on top. When they respond on social media, 5 seconds, like be on them. Mm-hmm. So set that up so that you can really help the team that way. And that would be really good. If you can report back, and that's the other thing I want you guys to do as admins and ops directors, don't forget to give great reports, meaning if you're sitting there, like we talked about at the beginning of the call, sharing some optimistic news, being like, hey, guess what? You know, Marianne, I found 3 exclusive listings at our office, and they're all willing to help us out here. So is it okay? I've created 3 social media posts. Here you go. Are we okay with that? And just take a look and just be like, here's the proactiveness of it. I would be impressed. I'd be like, you did a really great job. Congratulations. Boom. Done. So just kind of like what Val said also. We had a call with Kim Lambert with mortgages a couple of days ago, and we posted the questions that she asked for pre-approvals. Well, maybe you can take the pre-approvals off of your agent's plate and just be like, look, we've got questionnaires. So just be like, look, would you like us to circle to all of your buyers? Maybe it's a post saying, look, this is a questionnaire about the pre-approvals. We're happy. We have a system in place to help all buyers right now get their pre-approvals. Now, again, this is an out-of-the-box idea, so I'm not saying you have to do it, but everybody knows that I coach very out-of-the-box. So you can be that one team that sits there and says, we have a system in place to do virtual pre-approvals. Talk to your mortgage specialist before you go down this rabbit hole. You do not want to – be careful. I have a lot of fast implementers on this call, so be careful you don't do this in a way that's too wild coyote. Talk to your mortgage rep. To ask them for the questionnaires, use ours if you need to, that we've posted on our Facebook site. You can do whatever you want to do, but you may want to just be like, hey, we know that some of you need to do something. You need to get prepared. If you need your approvals done, here we have a checklist for you, and we have a virtual process. Reach out to us if you need help with that. Boom. Be cautious, admins, about being too excited. It's not the same marketing message that we're seeing out there right now, and I want to ask you about that, Val, is what is the fine line between being excited about, you know, the opportunities in the market versus being very careful about the message, because there's a lot of people who, like Air Canada, just got laid off today and things like that. So what's your thoughts between the messaging?
So if you're going to call the database, the number one thing is read the notes. Read like the last few comments and just get a general idea for how the flow has been going already before this even happened. And then, you know, we always take the DISC profile into consideration too. Is this a high D, a high I, high S? Because even if a high I, someone who's very like outgoing and loves to have conversations, and then they just get laid off, and then you call them, and it's like they still want to have a happy tone from you, but they just don't really want to talk about the market. So I say be very careful. Engage the call when you're calling somebody. And if you know these clients, if they're past clients, and you already have a sense of who they are, I'm hoping, just be mindful, really, is what it boils down to. If you can, and then on the flip side of that, if you could change someone's day by just a phone call, checking in from your local real estate office with no, you know, I'm not here to talk to you right now about if you're interested in buy-selling your home, just calling to see how you feel about your current, like, if you're happy where you are, if there's anything we could do, whatever that conversation looks like. It's just, I guess the perfect word, just be mindful. Just be conscious of what you're going into, but don't be scared. Don't be scared to pick up the phone because you're worried that maybe you're going to walk into a horrible conversation. Yesterday, our ISAs, when they did their end-of-day email to me, the one girl said 80% of the clients were really upset on the phone with me today because they thought I was calling. And so I said to her, I go, you know what? Tomorrow morning after I'm done my call at 9:30, we're going to do role play and script practicing, because maybe what we're doing is we're not watching our tone when we're having those conversations.
Exactly.
Maybe we need to flip our script.
Yeah. This isn't, you know, and this is a really good point, just to kind of, you know, dive into that for a second. From an administration perspective, you know, when people are losing jobs and things like that, you know, we're feeling very, you know, comfortable right now in the sense that, you know, Canada is doing the right thing. We're seeing the United States, you guys are buckling down pretty good. So we're seeing some really good positive things. So again, your programming in this time, you got to remember that just because we're being programmed and we know because we're looking at the real estate stats and we're positive about them, a good thing to remember as well is that 3 out of 5 recessions, the market was positive after. The worst recession hit that happened, I believe the recovery drop in home prices was 19%. So that was like the worst from the statistics that I've seen. So don't quote me on that either, because I haven't had a chance to double check the statistics, and I usually triple check the statistics. So if I haven't even gotten to double yet, that's what my admin's doing today. But it looks like out of the last 5 recessions, 3 didn't affect the prices. They actually went up, not down. And 2 went down, with the highest drop being 19% of pricing. So there are some, if you know, how you look at things is how you're going to perceive things. Just remember, the public is getting bombarded, and they have to, because if we don't put the media images out there of quarantine and staying home and things like that, guys, then this isn't going to do what, it's not going to save our economy, and it's not going to save our businesses. So that's why the media has to be putting messages out there going, look at this doom and gloom, look at what's happening. So understand that that's the mindset that all people probably who aren't seeing our industry, they're going in the background, they're going, holy smokes, they're like, this is doom and gloom. They're seeing layoffs today. Like, it's all going to start happening. So that's, and it already is happening. But that has to happen for people to understand the severity, because if they promoted good news right now or optimism on the TV, what would happen in Canada and United States and all across the world, UK, you know, everywhere, is people would be like, oh, it's not that bad. Let's get out there. Let's just do this. That is why. So remember that the programming people are getting is not great. So when you're calling them, calling people and being excited because your team or your business or you guys are doing better than you've ever done, I understand that, but that's not the time to, like, be very cautious. It's a call to see, I'm checking in real estate-wise, you know what, is there any questions that you have that I can answer or bring back to our CEO or Rainmaker to answer for you? And that's really ultimately what your call is like. If they take it into a different tone, they're like, yeah, everything's great, everything's perfect, mirror and match. Just mirror and match.
That's
whatever
right.
You're hearing, match them back. So just be really cautious about things like that, which is really important. Now, to pivot into some different things, let's say, okay, I didn't prep Val for this, so to be honest with you, this is kind of freelancing. If we were talking about admins who, let's say a CEO's like, look, I have an admin. Oh, here's one more thing before we go into this question, which we're going to wrap up on. The other thing you can be doing as admins, by the way, MVPs, is going over expenses. Okay, so you got to really look at that, and you got to do a little bit of marginalization. Be cautious about expenses versus investment. I love what Gary Keller, he's the CEO of Keller Williams, said a week ago. He says, you know what, you want to shave your expenses, not your investments. So it's kind of like, you know, when you're looking, and I'm saying that because I am a coach, but I can tell you right now, we have 700 clients and all of our clients are in production. And the reason why is because we're pushing, we know how to charter this water the best that we can. I'm on the phone till 4 o'clock every morning, checking with different markets, calling agents all over the world, checking in. So we are invested into making sure our clients get to the other side of this. If that is not an expense, that's an investment. If your coaches have helped you, I don't care what company you're with, if your coaches have helped you get to where you are today, then you absolutely need to keep investing in them because they will help you get through this. You drop it, and you know what? I'm just going to be honest with you. It's not an expense. An expense is what I'm talking about. So my admin went through my expenses, like all of our other teams, and she went through my expenses, and what we found is we found almost $400 a month in expenses that we really weren't using, like subscriptions to stuff. She chunked down $150 right off the bat within like 5 seconds. She's like, do you know about this? Do you know about that? I'm like, what? I was like, that's crazy. We pivoted and she says, you know what? You're pulling Starbucks. So she stopped the auto reload on my Starbucks card. And she said, I want you to consciously think about that. You're spending, okay, please, you know, be careful when you hear this. It's not something I endorse. She's like, you spend over $140 a month in Starbucks.
Oh, my goodness.
I know. I don't understand. But I didn't know that. Okay, I didn't know that because the stupid auto reload was just going, and I never paid attention to it. So I didn't know. So she's like, look, you're going to shave that off right now. Then she looked at my iTunes. She says, holy smokes. She goes, do you realize you have 4 subscriptions on iTunes? And I was like, yeah, but I don't even know what I'm paying. She's like, this. I'm like, what? What am I doing with that? And then she looked at other things. She's like, you realize you have this subscription, you have that. And so just taking out my subscriptions, really, that I wasn't using, shaved hundreds of dollars. That's what I'm talking about. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So really, guys, look at that and just kind of pivot to that and be like, what are the subscription expenses? What are the expenses like eating out, Starbucks, things like that? What do I have to get under control? Because at the end of the day, I do, the more that we can save from expenses that are just random, this is the biggest aha I had. I didn't know I was spending $120 a month on Starbucks. I really didn't. I had no clue. And I was like, I was so grateful. I was like, thank you. That's what I needed to see. And she was like, yeah, you do this, you're fine with that. And I was like, that's great. We don't have to cut our expenses as a company right now. But I can assure you that it was a great thing to have her, an exercise for her to come to me and be like, by the way, I only spent 2 hours on this and I've shaved $400 off. And I was like, wow, I was like, that's amazing. And I was like, even Google Play and things like that, she just swept through all the stuff and she was like, that's crazy. Anyway, I was very grateful for that. And she gave me some positive news, which I loved. And she was like, look, when we stopped the auto reload, she's like, do you really need to be like, you got an espresso machine. What are you doing at Starbucks? And she's like, and do you really need, like, we have an auto ink refill thing. And she's like, you don't need the auto ink refill. She's like, it's just charging you for ink you don't really need. I'm like, oh, my God. So I was like, that's great. And she's like, you got 6 Google Play things right now. She's like, do you really need those? I'm like, no. So I was very grateful for that. So we've set a challenge for her. I'm like, during this time, if she can just look at our expenses once a week and see what is not necessary, what are we not using this week? And she's just cut, cut, cut. So it's actually kind of fun. Now, as the last part, we only have a few minutes. So Val, quick question for you. And again, I said I would finish with this. What do you do if you're either a CEO on this call and you're cutting your admin's hours and all that kind of stuff and you're feeling terrible, or if you're an admin right now and you know that things are on the horizon because you're looking at your team, and let's be real, some of you guys might be on this call going, my team is doing nothing and we are literally worried that I'm going to lose my job. What can they do to earn income?
Great. That's actually a really good question. So one that we're actually talking about on our team as well. So to earn income for your team, guys, first of all, if anyone is feeling that way, I mean, we've got to get that thought out of our head, and we've got to start thinking about how we're going to make dollars for ourselves, like where we're going to get that from. And it comes from building your pipeline. I'm going to go back to, you know, going to your sphere of influence and touching base with everybody, building that. And it might not be income in this very minute, but it will come. It will come. What if you can get a deal to close, then it comes from there. However you guys have made your arrangements. If you're an owner who has an admin and you're thinking, I don't know if I can keep them going, I think it's you have to keep them going. You have to. We should be protecting that budget so that when times like this happen, we're okay. That's the first thing we want to make sure is we're taking care of our admin. So really, just like Marianne said, going through and looking at your expenses, because I would much rather cut an Audible, a Netflix account,
exactly,
whatever, to keep my admin, because they are your secret weapon. I'm telling you right now, you need them more than you want to admit sometimes.
It's true. Yeah. And I like what you just said. If you've got a Netflix account and an Audible account and all that kind of stuff, listen, cancel that shit. Like, really cancel it. Because if you're going to let go the person who supported your business, I'm a very big believer in that. Okay, my social media coaches and company, they're expensive. They're very expensive. We cut our ad spend. Okay, our ad spend was quite heavy. We cut our ad spend. We didn't cut them. Okay, I'm not going to abandon those guys when they need me the most. It's not going to happen. I have cleaners that come in and they clean our building every 2 weeks. They just said that 90% of their contracts were canceled and they're panicking. So we made the decision to help them. And I said, we're going to still pay for cleaning. We don't want you in our buildings because I don't believe it's essential service. But I said, I don't want you going out of business. I'm still going to pay for it. Just put it as a credit to my account, and then we're going to donate it to a client. So I'm not worried about stuff like that, but I'll tell you. Here's a couple other ideas, guys. First of all, if you guys are admins or operationals and whatnot, VPs, remember, you can go to your CEOs and rainmakers and say, listen, if I call my database and I get somebody who's thinking of buying or selling or something along those lines, because you may have people that are going to need that right now, then ask them for what realtors are getting, 25%. That's very reasonable, okay? They can write you a bonus check for 25% when it closes. So do that, meaning don't sit there and think EI or whatever or the cases. Go ahead and be like, you can get 25% referrals and ask your team. I don't think that they're going to say no to something like that. If they do, I'll find you an agent that'll pay you 25% in this market, probably 40%. But anyway, that's one idea. The next thing is pivot. If you believe right now there's a ton of agents who maybe could use some of your fee-for-service menu. So be creative. Yeah, be creative. Not everybody. There is a ton of people that are that have the budget. They're okay. Okay, so it's just because your CEO may not be able to carry this on, just remember, you can go and publish it out. Be like, real estate agents, do you need admin support? Go help other businesses. Do whatever it takes, but take your skills and be like, look, what am I really good at? You know what? I'm great at systems. Perfect. I'm great at this. I will do database calls for you. Put it out there. If you're sitting there going, I can do calls, I'm not afraid of that. Great. Then put it out there and be like, all you realtors who need somebody to call your database at this time, here's what I'm charging. Here's what I'm willing to do. Reach out to me. You can pivot too if you get laid off or if you're at risk or if your team leader says, look, I got to cut your hours down. Pivot, pivot, pivot. Think out of the box, get creative, and understand not everybody wants to lay people off right now. Okay. So pivot around and be like, how can you help? Maybe it's real estate offices, maybe it's other agents, whatever it is, shift and pivot. Make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. That's a great way to end it right there.
I love it. Me too. I think so. So here's the thing, guys. We loaded an hour of great stuff. Okay, so I hope you love it. Our next call is, believe it or not, 12 o'clock today. I'm going to share some mindset stuff. I'm going to share some ideas, and I'm going to hopefully get you guys jacked up, your team leaders and your rainmakers for the next 3 days. So we'll post this call up to our Facebook site. Val, I got to jump, but I just want to say thank you. I love the ideas. And please, guys, stay tuned, because what I'd love to do is get Val to do something regularly for you guys to give you support as administrators at the best time possible. So I will be sending something out this weekend, but I do have to talk to Val about it first. So, Val, thank you so much. I appreciate your time today, and we will be circling back to you on the weekend.
Awesome. Thank you for everything you're doing for everybody this week, Marianne. I love it.
Yeah, you got it, babe. It's only the beginning. So
I love it.
We will look forward. We will post something very shortly, so keep your eyes open. And by the way, guys, Val has arranged to get one of the best bonbon coaches doing a call with us next week on video marketing. So watch out for that. We're going to be announcing that today, too. So thanks, Val, and we will talk to you this weekend.
Bye. Have a great weekend.
Bye, girl.
Bye.